Hello and welcome inside of Warrior Gymnasium on the campus of Worland High School. I'm Jordan McKamey, and this is Warrior Basketball on the McKamey Broadcasting Network. We welcome you to the McGarvin and Taylor pregame show as Warrior Basketball against Rocky Mountain is just minutes away. We're pleased to bring you Warrior and Lady Warrior sports throughout the year, and it would not be possible without our sponsors. First, of course, our pregame sponsor, McGarvin and Taylor Real Estate. A host of other businesses have lent their support to this broadcast, and they include Hasco Industrial Supply, Pinnacle Bank, Diesel Pickup Specialists, Swing Trucking, McGarvin Moverly Construction, Sally's Classic Pizza, King's Carpet One, Admiral Beverage, Jay's Detail, Bryant Honey, and Sage Creek Land and Cattle. If your business is interested in advertising, now is the time. We're offering a free month of advertising to new customers who sign on for the rest of the Warrior Sports schedule through January. Contact me at McKameyBroadcasting@gmail.com for an advertising proposal, or call, text me directly at 307-431-1468. This is the McGarvin and Taylor pregame show. We're just minutes away from varsity boys basketball action at the Big Horn Basin Shootout. Warriors, Grizzlies, come your way next on the McKamey Broadcasting Network.
Trusted destination for homeowners and a valued member of the community. Discover our exciting new showroom, Room by Room, designed to elevate your shopping experience. A family-owned business that's also a good neighbor. King's Carpet One supports many charities in Worland and throughout the Big Horn Basin. King's Carpet One, giving our best to our customers and our community.
Smaller, a mini shack baller. I wouldn't have to yell when I talk to a toddler. I wish I had more leg room on a plane or a train. Life is tough when you're taller. Yeah, I shop it big and tall, but when it comes to my Pepsi, I like to keep it nice and small. A soft drink for your pocket, so light and refreshing. One sip, don't knock it.
So the next time you're at the checkout line, grab some Pepsi minis, but get your own, because these are all mine.
Hasco Industrial Supply is known for their industrial hoses, steel products, and trailers, but they'll surprise you with products for every customer. Check out Lazy One Clothing, matching pajamas, and more. Kiltec jackets for kids and adults, ready to protect you from old man winter. Stay cozy and stylish with Trail Crest blankets. Stuck? Not a chance with Yankum Kinetic ropes for every size ride. Give Hasco Industrial Supply a call at 347-6158 or stop in at 415 Bighorn Avenue in Worland. And welcome back inside the McGarvin and Taylor pregame show on the McKamey Broadcasting Network. Jordan McKamey alongside you. Third time we've talked to you tonight. Warrior varsity squad playing three games today after St. Stephen's canceled their trip to this tournament. Head coach Aaron Abel, also athletic director here at Worland High School, is left scrambling. Did a great job of getting Wyoming Indian up here. And Warriors took out Wyoming Indian 72-58 to start the tournament. Beat the Riverside Rebels 67-45, and now they'll wrap up this first day of Bighorn Basin Shootout action against the 2A Rocky Mountain Grizzlies. We are just about 10 minutes away from getting going between these two squads. The Grizzlies coming into this one 2-8 overall on the season as they try to get things right here. 4-4 overall on the regular season as well, with a couple of wins here. The Warriors have improved their record to 500. So the Warriors looking to build on a positive day and pick up their third victory of it and move above 500 for the first time. And Warriors going to have to try to not get caught looking forward to tomorrow's matchup against a very potent level Bulldog team that just took care of business against Wyoming Indian as well. So it'll be important to see that the Warriors stay focused on this one. Not that that's been an issue for this team, especially not Aaron Abel-led teams with the head coach out there trying to keep the focus on the task at hand. So expect the boys to come out, play with some high intensity. A lot of the things that they've wanted to get right and wanted to see with Warrior basketball have been transpiring today in terms of getting some easy buckets, forcing turnovers, putting the other team under pressure. It's been big for the Warriors here today as they picked up a couple of big victories, beating their opponents by a combined 32 points. So 32 points to the good for the Warriors here on this Friday from Worland High School. This is the Big Horn Basin Shootout and the McGarvin and Taylor pregame show. We step away again on the other side, get you a few keys to this game against Rocky Mountain, as well as heading towards the Northern Wyoming News starting lineups and opening tip-off here. Nightcap basketball from Worland High School on the McKamey Broadcasting Network.
Owned and operated company in Worland, Wyoming, offering trucking services for a host of industries. They have done extensive work in Wyoming, Montana, North Dakota, and Colorado, as well as surrounding Rocky Mountain states for the past 70 years. Their modern and up-to-date equipment allows them to provide full-service solutions for their customers' needs, from start to completion. Swing Trucking, 347-4161. Swing Trucking is a proud supporter of McKamey Broadcasting and Worland High School Athletics. Sally's Classic Pizza in Worland, the classiest pizza around. Sally's offers pizza made with fresh dough daily. Go with a classic single topping or load it up with the king. 10 toppings in all. Friday, football and pizza is a winning combination. The Warrior Special is available all school year. Get a large two-topping pizza and a two-liter for just $16.98. Fridays only. Sally's Classic Pizza, 1214 Bighorn Avenue, or call 347-2453.
Here in Wyoming, we live by the spirit of the Wild West.
Where the sun's a little brighter, where the snows that fall are a trifle wider, where the bonds of home are a wee bit tighter, that's where the West begins.
We're the bank that's with you wherever that spirit leads, because we're more than a bank in Wyoming. We're Wyoming in a bank. Pinnacle Bank, the way banking should be.
McGarvin Moberly Construction, a Worland institution, is celebrating 60 years in business. McGarvin Moberly is a specialized construction company with a focus on highway rehabilitation, maintenance, and reconstruction. For as many years as they've been in business, they've supported Worland High School Athletics, and that tradition continues with the support of McKamey Broadcasting. McGarvin Moberly wishes good luck and success to all Worland Warrior and Lady Warrior teams this season. McGarvin Moberly, 60 years and counting. Go Warriors! Ladies and gentlemen, are your diesel engines letting you down? Need a fix that's top-notch, fast, and reliable? DPS is your go-to destination. We are fueled by excellence and driven by expertise. From trucks to trailers, no job's too tough for our skilled crew. We've got the latest technology to get your diesel roaring again. Choose DPS, where you decide and we provide. Stop in at 1051 North 10th Street in Worland, call us 347-4410, or visit us on the web at dps307.com.
And we're back here on the McGarvin and Taylor pregame show. Jordan McKamey with you. Warrior basketball rounding out day one of Bighorn Basin Shootout basketball here from Worland High School. And Jordan McKamey bringing you the play-by-play action here. McGarvin and Taylor, our pregame show sponsor. McGarvin and Taylor Real Estate, 307-347-4271. Heading into the keys of the game, do want to mention, if you're looking for a sponsorship opportunity that perhaps is a little more on the cheap, although we don't like that word when we're talking about advertising, but a little more affordable, economical, if you will. We are looking for a keys to the game sponsor, so if that's something that may interest you, please get a hold of me, McKameybroadcasting@gmail.com, or contact me directly at 307-431-1468. keys to tonight's game for the Warriors. Again, they've been facing inter-classification or out-of-classification battles against some 2A squads. Same story here tonight against Rocky Mountain. Be the aggressor. Take it to this Rocky Mountain team. Put them under pressure early. The Warriors want to establish an inside-out game. What do we mean by that? Establish inside with Harris, with Owen Page down low. Try to expose the lane. Drives, and then the inside-out game comes from the defense collapsing against those drives and that work inside to give up some open shots, possibly for Tyshawn Swalstead, as well as Brian Caballero, Fisher Martinez, off the bench. Of course, we know that Owen Page and even Brody Teal will put it up from the outside, but an inside-out game tonight for the Warriors. And the last one, man up defensively. I don't mean man up as in, man up, get out there, do the job. I mean man up, pick your man up at midcourt or in full court press if that's where you're going to go. Too many times the Warriors have lost track of the ball handler, giving away some easy drives to the bucket. So man up defensively. Be the aggressor, establish an inside-out game, and man up defensively. Those are the keys to tonight's game for the Worland Warriors against the Rocky Mountain Grizzlies. This is the McGarvin and Taylor pregame show. Going to take our final break, and that's going to wrap up our McGarvin and Taylor pregame show coverage as we'll come back with our Northern Wyoming News starting lineups and opening tip-off here in the nightcap game of the Big Horn Basin Shootout at Worland High School. This is Warrior Basketball on the McKamey Broadcasting Network.
Shield. Join the war party. Through the generous support of the following businesses, this broadcast is made possible. Jay's Detail, located at 1626 U.S. Highway 20, 347-2071. Bryant Honey Incorporated, Pure Wyoming Honey and Pollination Services. Sage Creek Land and Cattle Company, with a special thanks to John and Steven Snyder. Want to join the war party? Call or text 307-431-1468 or email McKameyBroadcasting@gmail.com.
In its 24 years in Worland, King's Carpet One has become a trusted destination for homeowners and a valued member of the community. Discover our exciting new showroom, Room by Room, designed to elevate your shopping experience. A family-owned business that's also a good neighbor, King's Carpet One supports many charities in Worland and throughout the Big Horn Basin. King's Carpet One, giving our best to our customers and our community.
Smaller, a mini Shaq baller. I wouldn't have to yell when I talk to a toddler. I wish I had more leg room on a plane or a train. Life is tough when you're taller. Yeah, I shop it big and tall. But when it comes to my Pepsi, I like to keep it nice and small. A soft drink for your pocket. So light and refreshing, one sip, don't knock it.
So the next time you have to check out line, grab some Pepsi minis, but get your own. Cause these are all mine.
Hasco Industrial Supply is known for their industrial hoses, steel products, and trailers, but they'll surprise you with products for every customer. Check out Lazy One Clothing, matching pajamas, and more. Kiltech jackets for kids and adults, ready to protect you from old man winter. Stay cozy and stylish with Trail Crest blankets. Stuck? Not a chance with Yankum Kinetic ropes for every size ride. Give Hasco Industrial Supply a call at 347-6158 or stop in at 415 Bighorn Avenue in Worland.
Welcome back inside of Warrior Gymnasium campus of Worland High School. A frigid day across Washakie County, so understand if you can't make it to the gym, why not join us here and feel like you are inside the gym from the comfort of your own couch. We're glad to have you along here on the broadcast on McKamey Broadcasting. Time to jump into our Northern Wyoming News starting lineups. Tonight's starting lineup's going to look like this for the Rocky Mountain Grizzlies. They're going to be in their away brown and gold jerseys, RM on the back of those jerseys. Grizzlies across the front, I believe. Double check that in a moment. They'll go with number 3, Bryce Haslam. Number 5, Cole Minshaw. Number 30, Noah Johnson. Number 30, Leif Files, and number 44, Hayden Wambeke. Haslam, Minchow, Johnson, Files, and Wambeke for the Rocky Mountain Grizzlies. And we're actually going to get some introductions here tonight. First time tonight we've done it, so that's going to be fun there. For the Worland Warriors, they'll go with their standard starting five that they've gone with throughout most of the season. Number four, Mason Decker. Number 10, Tyshawn Swalstead. Number 13, Owen Page. Number 21, Brian Caballero. And number 34, Chase Harris. So scratch the introductions. We are ready for basketball. That is our Northern Wyoming News starting lineups, and we'll get to the Northern Wyoming News tip-off here momentarily. As the Warriors will go to the middle, it'll be Harris taking on Files for the opening tip here, presented by the Northern Wyoming News weekly publication, available online. Subscriptions are QR code for the McKamey Broadcasting YouTube homepage via QR code each and every week there. Big thank you out to Carla Pomeroy and the staff at Northern Wyoming News. We are ready for action here on the McKamey Broadcasting Network and the Northern Wyoming News tip-off, controlled by your Worland Warriors. Swalstead with it. Get back for Page. Got a little 2-3 jump-out zone here from the Grizzlies. See what the Warriors try to do to break this down. Got it for Decker. Throws it across court. Ends up being for Swalstead. Swalstead, shot fake there. Takes on the three. No. Owen Page able to get inside. Put the shot up. That also misses. So the Warriors, couple of chances here on that opening possession, and they come up empty. Ball into the hands of Haslam. Caballero, sweltering defense there as he loses the dribble. And almost a five-second count here. That was as close as you can get. Got it off for Cole Minchow. Minchow gets a screen, pulls up. Deep two straight away. Got it, lefty. Cole Minchow opens up the scoring here for the Rocky Mountain Grizzlies and for the game. 2-0 Pinnacle Bank scoreboard here with a minute gone by from Worland High School. Swalstead and Page and Caballero exchanging across the perimeter. Caballero for Page. Swalstead, right wing, free throw extended. He'll take on another shot from the outside, and nice rebound inside by Decker. Goes back up, crawls over the backside. Long rebound chance for Swalstead. Outside, Caballero, shot fake there. Decker down the baseline, puts the shot up. No. Harris, is it going to be another chance for the Warriors? Yes. Outside right for Page. He wants to go down the baseline, lost it there. And out of bounds, 6:23 to go there. Warriors, a number of offensive opportunities there, but could not finish it off. Decker picks up Minchow right at midcourt. Noah Johnson, and now Files with it. Into the corner it goes for Minchow for three. The lefty let it go, could not hit, and a good rebound in the end by Brian Caballero. And then here goes Page, coast to coast there. Got the inside position, and the Warriors are on the board and tie it up 2-2. Pinnacle Bank scoreboard with 5:50 to go in the opening quarter of basketball. Outside it goes. Give it off for Files. First touch here now for Wambeke. Three on the way outside for Bryce Haslam is good. Well, the Grizzlies starting off shooting well from deep. Couple of deep shots up, a deep two, and now a three to give them a 5-2 lead. Pinnacle Bank scoreboard. Remember, Warriors' third contest here of the day. Backside for Swalstead. He's trying to find his range. Third shot up, third shot missed, but then two Grizzlies battle each other for it and knock it out of bounds. So keep it here with the Warriors on the offensive side. Baseline inbounds play. Page going to cue this one up. Come in deep for Chase Harris. Back down low for Decker. Reach and foul there. Going to go on the Grizzlies. Going to tag Wambeke with his first foul. Page back again to inbound this play. Comes in for Harris again. Work it around the perimeter right to left. Nice little dive inside Chase Harris. He got freed up underneath. Great find by Decker, as that is a bucket for the Warriors to cut the lead to one. Ball outside Files. He's going to walk with it there as he lost it on the collection and then took too many steps. So the Warriors going to take back over, try to take the lead on this trip down the floor. Owen Page has the reins now for the Warriors into the front court. He strides. Caballero. Couple of dribbles. Back for Swalstead. Well, no-look pass to the outside. Not there. Ball tipped around. Rocky Mountain going to end up taking it away. And they'll come ahead as the Warriors turn it over. Oh, nice little fake pass move. Give Minchow there to get inside. If that was intentional, that was a really nice play. Not sure if he tried to drop it off, and it got tipped right back to him, but an easy finish inside, and the Grizzlies go up by three. Warriors realizing they're going to have to be crisp with the passing here on this zone pressure from the Grizzlies. Back for Caballero, straight away three. That one's off, but Decker's there for a backside rebound. Up and good. Warriors doing nice around the hoop here so far early on in this contest. Back to a one-point game. Warriors yet to enjoy a lead so far today, seeing if they can get a stop now. Minchow outside, tipped away by Page, and he'll stay with the Grizzlies as Tyler Kidgel and Brody Teal into the game for the first time for Mason Decker and Tyshawn Swalstead. Head coach Aaron Abel giving some instruction there off of the sideline. Minchow into the corner for Files. Now back up around the horn. It goes through Haslam. He's down low. Harris there. This is a mismatch. Harris the advantage. Three on the way. Minchow corner, and man, he's got the range. That time the lefty. It's a high arcing shot as the Warriors try to go the other way as Page lost it momentarily. Still loose, and finally the Grizzlies are able to take it away with a four-point lead, 10-6. Also seeing Tucker Jackson in for the Grizzlies. Goes to the hoop. Couldn't hit the shot. Was Haslam. Nice rebound by Harris on the inside. Warriors haven't quite settled into this game yet with 3:13 to go in the first quarter. Pinnacle Bank scoreboard 10-6 Grizzlies. Kidgel down low. Teal. He's looking for options. Back for Caballero. He's open for three. Spinning. Good looking shot. Wouldn't go in, but there's Owen Page on the backside for an easy two. The Warriors pretty much three out of four putbacks here for the Warriors. So the Grizzlies got to get better positioned defensively, but the Warriors taking advantage. Files tried to go downhill against Page, forced out right back into the hands of Haslam. Minchow, they left him open again. High arcing three is down. He's got the feeling here in the opening quarter. 10 of the Grizzlies, 13 points, including two from downtown. Back to a five-point game, 13-8. It's a long shooting motion as well. Warriors need to just close that out and can really disrupt that that shooting motion. Ball outside for Page. Gets underneath his man. Up and good. Nice position there. Owen Page, as he's got 6 points for the Warriors. 13-10. 2:08 to go. First quarter. Pinnacle Bank scoreboard. Has some shot fake there. Kidgel. Good defense. Use the baseline there as another defender. Minchow, Haslam, wants to go to the baseline again. Spin move there. Kidgel, nice defense there. Stayed on his feet as Harris couldn't collect it, though, and it ends up with the Grizzlies. Little mid-range jumper up, no good there for Tucker Jackson, and the Warriors able to get it with Teal. Up ahead, Caballero. Handoff for Page. Kidgel. Back for Caballero. He'll take on the three, trying to find the range. Could not. Teal, another rebound. Another reset opportunity for the Warriors. Kidgel drives downhill. Passed a couple players. Scoop shot is up. No good. And finally, the Grizzlies able to clear off the glass. And then it's taken right back by the Warriors. Up and good for Brody Teal. And now the Warriors can set up the pressure. 13-12, nice forced turnover there as Teal finished it off, his first bucket. Jackson outside, three on the way for Haslam, was a little bit short, rattled around, almost got the shooter's roll, but Brian Caballero able to bring that one down. Kidgel in the corner, he'll try a three, that one's off. Owen Page the rebound, leaning in, up and good, and the Warriors' second chance points are building as they've got 10 of them now here in the quarter. Warriors' first lead of the day, 14-13 with 35 seconds to go, and now a blocking foul going to go against Caballero. He tried to force his man out of bounds and bumped off Johnson that time, so a foul on Caballero with Grant Page coming in along with Ryan Denise, Fisher Martinez, Corbin Butte, so a quick little hit here for the Warriors starters. Also see Wambakie check back into the game for the Grizzlies. And number 21, Joaquin Sheeler. Ball works around, Haslam going downhill, ran out of room there. Nice tie up by Kigel. Stays with the Grizzlies on the possession arrow. Ball up top with Haslam. Outside Minchow. That's a heat check there as that one ends up short. And the Warriors smartly let that one roll out of bounds. Martinez into the front court with 20 seconds to go. Deniz almost out in some trouble as Page holds in the corner. Now give it for Kigel. 10 seconds to get a shot off. Outside Martinez. Give it inside Deniz. Puts up a little fall-away jumper. No. Butte back up. Page gets a rebound, and he is fouled with 1.7 to go for the Warriors. Chance to build on the minimal one-point lead here. 1.7 left on the Pinnacle Bank scoreboard. Warriors now at the line with Grant Page. And again, call these second-chance opportunities as well. As Page continues to be good from the free throw line, he was 3 of 4 throughout the first couple of games and knocks down another. Warriors got to defend on this last shot potential, whether it's a make or a miss. In and out, no. Ball tipped around, almost tipped in by the Warriors, and the Grizzlies won't get a shot off. After one quarter, it's competitive, 15-13. Warriors on top on the Pinnacle Bank scoreboard. Second quarter on your way next. This is Warrior Basketball on the McKamey Broadcasting Network.
Family-owned and operated company in Worland, Wyoming, offering trucking services for a host of industries. They have done extensive work in Wyoming, Montana, North Dakota, and Colorado, as well as surrounding Rocky Mountain states for the past 70 years. Their modern and up-to-date equipment allows them to provide full-service solutions for their customers' needs, from start to completion. Swing Trucking, 347-4161. Swing Trucking is a proud supporter of McKamey Broadcasting and Worland High School Athletics. Sally's Classic Pizza in Worland, the classiest pizza around. Sally's offers pizza made with fresh dough daily. Go with a classic single topping or load it up with the king. 10 toppings in all. Friday, football, and pizza is a winning combination. The Warrior Special is available all school year. Get a large two-topping pizza and a two-liter for just $16.98. Fridays only. Sally's Classic Pizza, 1214 Bighorn Avenue, or call 347-2453.
And welcome back inside of Worland High School. Jordan McKamey with you. Wanted to mention the Lady Warriors playing in the Big Horn Basin Shootout as well. Level Rocky Mountain. The Warriors, Lady Warriors beat Rocky Mountain 41-24, and they're currently playing Level. Have not got an update about that score, but it'll be Warrior basketball here out of the quarter break. Got Paige, Swalstead, Caballero, Harris, and Decker out there. So back to the starting five. Warriors backside, Swalstead thought about the three. Nothing there. Caballero freed up straight away for three. That's no good. Page, again, superior position through the contact. Couldn't finish, but he'll head to the free throw line again. The Warriors have dominated the glass. Sends Owen Page to the free throw line. He's already got 8 points here in this opening quarter, or this opening half. Make it 9 points. So trying to go double digits here in the first 9 minutes of the game. Second one is also up and good. So the Warriors lead up to four, and then now the Grizzlies make kind of a small mental error and went over the line on the handoff there. So a kind of a quick turnover that time for Rocky Mountain. Whereas inbounds for Tyshawn Swalstead, goes downhill, get it back for Harris. Now Decker. Caballero, Swalstead, and Page. Warriors patient here. Swalstead, try to double team that again. Tyshawn a little bit smaller. Some teams as he launches up a three. That one also no good. Warriors have yet to hit a three, but Chase Harris has another offensive rebound, but then the Warriors throw it away trying to get it inside for Page. And now the Grizzlies set up their offense. Min Chau with it now. Give for Files. Tries to go baseline. Then the Warriors almost didn't close out in time to get up a three. But it'll go back for Haslam. Haslam wants to drive. Files in the right corner for three. Got it. As the Grizzlies have been hot from the outside so far in this game. Back to a one-point game. 17-16. Caballero. Swalstead. Back for Caballero. Shot fake there. Shut off on the drive, and now Page has it directing traffic. Ball now for Page. Having trouble. Haven't got Chase Harris a touch on the inside. It's kind of tough against this 2-3 zone. Now Page has it. He wants to go to work. Goes inside. Leaves it a little bit short there. Backside rebound, though, by Decker as he goes up, and he is fouled. See if they called that on the ground or on the shot. So Wambeke going to get his second personal of the game, and that'll send Decker to the line for two. Mason with a couple of points already in this game. 6:22 to go in the first half, and Decker leaves that one short. Wouldn't be surprised if there's a few wobbly legs out there for the Warriors. Got to really finish that motion. This one digs a little deeper into the hammies. No good, but there's Harris with the rebound, and Chase in and out. Couldn't get his first bucket. It was a nice offensive board, but the Warriors come up empty on that trip. Grizzlies look to take the lead, and then it's taken away quickly by Owen Page. He'll go the distance here against his man, up and good. Owen Page for the deuce. Warriors back on top by three. Min Chau into the corner, in some trouble, tipped away by Harris. It's loose now, and then Harris is a little bit too much pace that time as he'll foul Noah Johnson, Harris's first personal. Sideline inbounds play now. Ball going to come into the backcourt now for Min Chau. Min Chau out to the right, and going to call a foul here. That's on Caballero. That's his second. So a sideline or a baseline inbounds play coming. Get it outside for Min Chau. Good defense here from Page as he knocks it away. As the Warrior student section has to back up here, is Min Chau inbounds now for the Grizz. Ball comes in for Haslam. Warriors, again, applying a lot of defensive pressure here. And, oh, Haslam walked with it there, but they missed it. And now a illegal screen. That time going to go against Leif Files, his first personal foul. Just the third of the quarter on the Grizzlies. Two more and put it Warriors at the line for a couple. Warriors come ahead. Ball inside. Harris for Page. Ball's kind of stuck in the middle there. Page went up, couldn't finish, and Files able to come away with the rebound. And then nearly taken right back by Owen Page. And Min Chau tried to sell a little contact there, but referee Scott Fritzler not having any of it. And then Haslam gets freed right to the bucket. Warriors got turned around and didn't see what was going on. Timeout on the floor here taken by head coach Pat Whitland and the Rocky Mountain Grizzlies. 19-18, Warriors on top by one here on the McKamey Broadcasting Network.
Here in Wyoming, we live by the spirit of the Wild West.
Now where the sun's a little brighter, where the snows that fall are a trifle whiter, where the bonds of home are a wee bit tighter, that's where the West begins.
We're the bank that's with you wherever that spirit leads. Because we're more than a bank in Wyoming, we're Wyoming in a bank. Pinnacle Bank, the way banking should be.
And we're back here on the McKamey Broadcasting Network. Big Horn Basin Shootout. Worland Warriors, Rocky Mountain Grizzlies in the nightcap game here. And the Warriors and Grizzlies locked up in a tight one here. It's 19-18. Warriors with the basketball out of the timeout. So Warriors with it. A couple of players getting some referee instruction there. Tyler Kidgel into the game along with Brody Teal as well. Warriors trying to get something working. Kidgel down low for Decker. Spin it across for Caballero. And now Kidgel. Caballero. Teal. Back for Brian Caballero. 4:35 to go here in the second quarter. Ball down low for Decker. Needs some help. Finds it up top in Caballero. Good ball movement by the Warriors. Little baseline jumper for Decker. Too strong there. Backside rebound taken down by Minchow. And the Grizzlies' chance to take the lead again on this trip down. See if the Warriors can ratchet up defensively. Haslam wanted to see if he could go to the bucket again. Nice recovery, though, by Kidgel. Outside, Files takes on a three, and he knocked it down. Right now, the Grizzlies' best friend is the three ball as they take a two-point lead on the Pinnacle Bank scoreboard, 21-19. Ball up top here, Caballero and Haslam competing for that one, and Haslam got a tip, but Caballero was standing in front, so got back into that one in the backcourt. Harris, he wants to go inside, has to kick out Caballero. Now for Decker. Right wing now for Kidgel, and Harris can't handle the pass, and here come the Grizzlies. Warriors not quite as crisp as they've been throughout the day. Three on the way, air ball that time, no good by Noah Johnson and out of bounds. Fisher Martinez, Corbin Butte into the game now for Decker and Caballero. So got Martinez out there now. Head coach Aaron Abel wants to talk things over. His team trailing 21-19. Pinnacle Bank scoreboard back next with more Warrior basketball on the McKamey Broadcasting Network.
Construction, a Worland institution, is celebrating 60 years in business. McGarvin Moberly is a specialized construction company with a focus on highway rehabilitation, maintenance, and reconstruction. For as many years as they've been in business, they've supported Worland High School athletics, and that tradition continues with the support of McKamey Broadcasting. McGarvin Moberly wishes good luck and success to all Worland Warrior and Lady Warrior teams this season. McGarvin Moberly, 60 years in counting. Go Warriors! Ladies and gentlemen, are your diesel engines letting you down? Need a fix that's top-notch, fast, and reliable? DPS is your go-to destination. We are fueled by excellence and driven by expertise. From trucks to trailers, no job's too tough for our skilled crew. We've got the latest technology to get your diesel roaring again. Choose DPS where you decide and we provide. Stop in at 1051 North 10th Street in Worland. Call us 347-4410 or visit us on the web at dps307.com.
Timeout wrapping up here for the Warriors and the Grizzlies as the Warriors took that full timeout trying to deal with the zone defense of the Grizzlies. Again, got to try to way to work it inside out. We talked about an inside-out game, haven't had a whole lot of inside. We've had the second chance points, which have been nice. Harris up top wants to go downhill. Inside out it goes for Harris, trying to go backside now for Teal. And I think last touch by the Grizzlies, no foul, so we'll stay with the Warriors. 3:13 to go, ball in for Harris. Outside Fisher Martinez for three, won't go though. Warriors can't buy one from the outside right now as here comes Minchow and the Grizzlies the other way. Drop it off for Johnson, now Files. Files wants to go baseline clear out there, not whistled though. 2:52 to go, and the Warriors have yet to hit a three in this one while the Grizzlies have hit five. Minchow needed some help, finally found it in Files. Dump off, Files back for another three, and that one's short, won't go. But rebound by Johnson puts up the shot, no. Harris, rebound there, ball tipped away, going to go back to the Grizz. Ball just not bouncing the Warriors' way right now. 2:23 to go. Haslam going to go to the backside there as it's shut off. Corbin Butte providing some help and tipped out of bounds by Kidgel. Good defensive hands there. Both teams have made eight field goals. Five of them have been threes for Rocky Mountain. Minchow up top, defended by Teal. Rocky trying to set something up here, trying to go down the lane. Again, Haslam shut off. Harris got in a bad position, but blocked it from behind there on Tucker Jackson. Great play by Harris. He got beat on the post move, but made up for it with the swat, and Grant Page will come in. Ball inbounds now for Files. Johnson. They want to go for Files inside against Kidgel. Inside out, three-pointer on the way for Johnson. Can't get it. Files rebound inside, and finally crashing it is Corbin Butte. And then the Warriors come the other way through Fisher Martinez. All the way to the hoop. Scoop layup is good for Fisher Martinez. As the Warriors knot things up at 21, just two ties, two lead changes thus far in this one. Grizzlies in the corner with Johnson. Quick touch for Jackson. And then miscommunication there by the Grizzlies. They throw it out of bounds, turn it over. Quick change there between Harris and Page. Harris back in there. Maybe just some quick instruction from the coaching staff. Fisher Martinez in control of the offense for the Warriors. Kick it to Kidgel. Now Harris in the corner, going to dribble top of the key. Give it for Brody Teal. Corbin Butte. Well, skip pass here for Kidgel. Warriors have a chance to get inside that zone. Did get it, though, and then Butte has to track it down in the backcourt, and the Warriors turn it over. When the Grizz gamble, the Warriors have to take a chance to get inside, and that time they just couldn't take advantage. Ball inbounds now for Minchow. Gives for Files. Files thought about the three. Has a man pass by. Takes it on. Misses the shot. Martinez had it tipped out of his hands and out of bounds. And it'll go to the Warriors. Warriors happy to see a three not go down. And then almost thrown away there. A little miscommunication as head coach Aaron Abel was given some instruction from the sideline. Had Martinez's attention as Teal comes up top. Skip pass now for Martinez. Butte, give for Teal. Now into the corner for Butte. Down low for Harris, like the inside game here. Harris working, goes for Teal. Nice find there as Brody Teal goes up for the deuce. The Warriors on top, 23-21, Pinnacle Bank scoreboard. 19 seconds left to go here in the first half. Warriors with the lead by two. Up top, it is Johnson, deep outside, Files. No, sets for three, left wing. That one airballed. Nothing there, and then it's rebounded back in here for the Grizzlies. Warriors' chance at the final shot. 3 seconds, 2 seconds. Teal pulls up at the buzzer. Wouldn't go down as the Warriors head into the locker room with a tight two-point lead, 23-21 over the Rocky Mountain Grizzlies. It's been a defensive battle. Well, it's been the battle of the Warriors not being able to get inside just yet so far in this game. Considering the lack of execution, I think head coach Aaron Abel may be satisfied that his team is actually leading by two, because against other competition could possibly be a larger deficit. We'll take a break here, be back with a halftime show, give you a scoring summary, keys to the second half as well. We will prep you for half number two action. From the Big Horn Basin Shootout, Worland Warriors, Rocky Mountain Grizzlies, Warriors on top, 23-21, Pinnacle Bank scoreboard. Back after this on the McKamey Broadcasting Network.
Border Shield, join the war party. Through the generous support of the following businesses, this broadcast is made possible. Jay's Detail, located at 1626 U.S. Highway 20, 347-2071. Bryant Honey Incorporated, Pure Wyoming Honey and Pollination Services. Sage Creek Land and Cattle Company, with a special thanks to John and Steven Snyder. Want to join the war party? Call or text 307-431-1468 or email McKameyBroadcasting@gmail.com.
In its 24 years in Worland, King's Carpet One has become a trusted destination for homeowners and a valued member of the community. Discover our exciting new showroom, Room by Room, designed to elevate your shopping experience. A family-owned business that's also a good neighbor, King's Carpet One supports many charities in Worland and throughout the Big Horn Basin. King's Carpet One, giving our best to our customers and our community.
I was a little bit smaller, a mini shack baller. I wouldn't have to yell when I talk to a toddler. I wish I had more leg room on a plane or a train. Life is tough when you're taller. Yeah, I shop it big and tall, but when it comes to my Pepsi, I like to keep it nice and small. A soft drink for your pocket, so light and refreshing, one sip, don't knock it.
So the next time you have to check out line, grab some Pepsi minis, but get your own, because these are all mine, mine, mine.
Hasco Industrial Supply is known for their industrial hoses, steel products, and trailers, but they'll surprise you with products for every customer. Check out Lazy One Clothing, matching pajamas, and more. Kiltech jackets for kids and adults, ready to protect you from old man winter. Stay cozy and stylish with Trail Crest blankets. Stuck? Not a chance with Yankum Kinetic ropes for every size ride. Give Hasco Industrial Supply a call at 347-6158 or stop in at 415 Bighorn Avenue in Worland.
Welcome back inside a Worland High School halftime score. Worland Warriors 23, Rocky Mountain Grizzlies 21 in a tightly contested battle. The Warriors' third varsity contest of the day, so testing the legs and the conditioning of this Warriors squad. Looking at the halftime scoring summary for these two squads, looking at the Rocky Mountain Grizzlies, Bryce Haslam with 5, Cole Minshaw with 10, pair of threes for him, 6 other points belonging to Leif Files, 2 threes there. So 5 threes are down. They have 8 field goals, 5 of them from downtown. So the Warriors truly, if you looked at it, they only gave up 3 2-point buckets, and one of them was nearly a 3 early on in the game. So that's something to be positive for the Warriors. As well, the Warriors no threes in that opening half. 4 points for Brody Teal, 2 for Mason Decker, 12 points for Owen Page, 2 for Fisher Martinez, 2 for Chase Harris, and 1 point for Grant Page to give the Warriors their 23-21 lead. Let's go back into our keys to the game in this one. Be the aggressor. I'm not sure that the Warriors would say after that they were the aggressor. They led 15-13 after one, now lead 23-21 after two. Established an inside-out game. Well, they tried, couldn't really get it inside. Late on in that half, they finally started to do that. Felt like the three-pointers, you can always get those against a zone defense. What you want to do is get that defense to collapse. And I imagine at halftime that's going to be something head coach Aaron Abel looks at. Man up defensively. Well, defensively, they've done a good job. So I'd say call it 1.5 out of 3 for the Warriors, seeing if they can improve on that in the second half here from Worland High School. Rocky Mountain Grizzlies already out of the halftime locker room. Warriors have yet to emerge. Halftime shootout here at the at Worland High School. Is take a look on the floor. I see some former Warriors out there. Court Gonzalez trying his shot in the comfy Uggs. Maybe not the same as your standard athletic shoe there. So the former Warriors in the house supporting the current Warriors squad that is trying to pick up their third victory of this Bighorn Basin shootout. We'll remind you tomorrow the Warriors will be back in action here from Worland High School. Had to have some changes going on just because the St. Stephen's Eagles canceled on head coach and athletic director Aaron Abel. So we had to move some things around. So looking at the new schedule, the Warriors will round up this tournament tomorrow at 12:30 against Lovell. So that'll be the final game of the weekend. No championship like usual in this Bighorn Basin shootout. A couple of teams having to pull out. Glen Rock had to cancel their trip as well. So safety precautions, the reasons that those teams not involved. Going to take our final break of the halftime show. On the other side, we prep you for half number two and get you to third quarter action. Halftime score, Worland Warriors 23, Rocky Mountain 21 on the Pinnacle Bank scoreboard. Worland Warrior basketball rolls into the second half next on the McKamey Broadcasting Network.
owned and operated company in Worland, Wyoming, offering trucking services for a host of industries. They have done extensive work in Wyoming, Montana, North Dakota, and Colorado, as well as surrounding Rocky Mountain states for the past 70 years. Their modern and up-to-date equipment allows them to provide full-service solutions for their customers' needs, from start to completion. Swing Trucking, 347-4161. Swing Trucking is a proud supporter of McKamey Broadcasting and Worland High School Athletics. Sally's Classic Pizza in Worland, the classiest pizza around. Sally's offers pizza made with fresh dough daily. Go with a classic single topping or load it up with the king. 10 toppings in all. Friday, football and pizza is a winning combination. The Warrior Special is available all school year. Get a large two-topping pizza and a 2-liter for just $16.98. Fridays only. Sally's Classic Pizza, 1214 Bighorn Avenue, or call 347-2453.
Here in Wyoming, we live by the spirit of the Wild West.
Now where the sun's a little brighter, where the snows that fall are a trifle whiter, where the bonds of home are a wee bit tighter, that's where the West begins.
We're the bank that's with you wherever that spirit leads. Because we're more than a bank in Wyoming, we're Wyoming in a bank. Pinnacle Bank, the way banking should be.
McGarvin Moberly Construction, a Worland institution, is celebrating 60 years in business. McGarvin Moberly is a specialized construction company with a focus on highway rehabilitation, maintenance, and reconstruction. For as many years as they've been in business, they've supported Worland High School Athletics, and that tradition continues with the support of McKamey Broadcasting. McGarvin Moberly wishes good luck and success to all Worland Warrior and Lady Warrior teams this season. McGarvin Moberly, 60 years in counting. Go Warriors! Ladies and gentlemen, are your diesel engines letting you down? Need a fix that's top-notch, fast, and reliable? DPS is your go-to destination. We are fueled by excellence and driven by expertise. From trucks to trailers, no job's too tough for our skilled crew. We've got the latest technology to get your diesel roaring again. Choose DPS, where you decide and we provide. Stop in at 1051 North 10th Street in Worland, call us 347-4410, or visit us on the web at dps307.com. The Warrior Supporter Shield. Join the war party. Through the generous support of the following businesses, this broadcast is made possible. Jay's Detail, located at 1626 U.S. Highway 20, 347-2071. Bryant Honey Incorporated, Pure Wyoming Honey and Pollination Services. Sage Creek Land and Cattle Company, with a special thanks to John and Steven Snyder. Want to join the war party? Call or text 307-431-1468 or email McKameybroadcasting@gmail.com.
And welcome back inside Worland High School, Bighorn Basin Shootout nightcap game. Worland Warriors 23, Rocky Mountain Grizzlies 21 at the half. Warriors trying to make it a 3-for-3 day in victories here. And we'll see if they can come out with a renewed energy, as it'll be Rocky Mountain basketball to start half number two. You got Brody Teal, Tyshawn Svalstead, Owen Page, Brian Caballero, and Chase Harris out there for the Warriors. Cole Minshew looks like Haslam out there. Bryce Haslam, Cole Minshew, Noah Johnson, Leif Files, and Hayden Wambeke. So the same starting five as we saw in the opening half. And then Tyshawn Svalstead quickly takes it away for the Warriors and gets an easy bucket to start the second half as he took it away on the inbounds play. So first offensive set here for the Grizz. Try to go inside. Files looked like he walked with it there. Nothing called, though. And there's Chase Harris with a strong rebound. Tried to throw it up for Teal, a little too strong. And it's taken back by Noah Johnson. 30 seconds gone by and a high-energy start here to half number two. And it's taken right back away by Brian Caballero. Streaking to the bucket. Warriors taking it away a couple of times and able to cash in for some easy buckets. 27-21, Warriors looking to set a tone here to start half number two. Ball in the hands of Johnson, trying to get a screen there, goes down to the baseline, and Caballero going to commit a blocking foul. Caballero's third.
Got beat on that first step as the Grizz are going to try to inbound it. Got it for Files, and then Harris left his feet, so he's going to get tagged for a personal. So back-to-back fouls by the Warriors. Grant Page going to come in the game for Harris. Just his second personal, but comes out of the game. As the Grizzlies try to set something up, and an old work around there, and Haslam missed the bunny as the Grizzlies come away frustrated there. And Swalstead in transition for three. He buried it. Rainmaker from Tyshawn Swalstead as he's got five here in the half. And the Warriors' first triple of the game. 9-point lead now here for the Warriors on a 7-0 run to start the second half. Johnson, inside it goes, almost tipped away there by Page, but right back into the hands of the Grizzlies. Teal defending high here, almost a five-second call, and it is as Brody Teal sticks to Cole Minshew like glue that time around and gets the ball back for the Warriors. 6:25 to go here in the third quarter, and the Warriors have come out aggressively in half number two. Caballero to Teal. Swalstead going to bounce back outside. Teal now trying to get it for Page, but it's read nicely by Files. And now Minshew going to go down the lane. Shot is up, no good. And a kind of a bad foul there by Brody Teal. Just kind of bodied up his man. He had already in good position. It was already a tough shot for Minshew. Kind of bailed him out with the foul there. So that'll send Minshew to the line. First free throws attempted of the game for the Grizz, and first one's up and no good. Again, Warriors on a 7-0 run. Minshew trying to put an end to that and does get that one to crawl over the top and down. Warriors set up offensively again. Through Teal, skip pass for Swalstead. Shot fake there. Now tries to dribble out of trouble. Lost it, but right into the hands of Caballero. Swalstead. Give for Page. Over the top comes Minshew. That'll be a foul on him. Warriors baseline inbounds play coming up. Ball comes in. Out top for Grant Page. Now Swalstead. Teal for Caballero. One dribble out of trouble, Swalstead takes on another three. That one way short, though. Didn't quite get set in the right spot as Files comes away with the rebound. And here comes Rocky Mountain setting up offensively. Bryce Haslam wants to drive. No, he's going to take on a three from the left wing. That one missed everything, and Owen Page has the rebound. Warriors through Swalstead, give for Page, right down the lane he goes, to the hoop plus the harm. Three-point play opportunity for Owen Page. Good find inside there for the Warriors. And with Johnson out of the game, we see Joaquin Sheeler into the game. Tyshawn Swalstead out. Fisher Martinez in. We'll also see Tucker Jackson check in on the make as Page knocks it down. He's 3 of 3 from the free throw line. He's got 15 points here in this contest for the Warriors. Five, 10 to go here in the third quarter. Warriors on top by 11. Biggest lead of the day, 33. To 22, and the ball tipped around by the Warriors, almost taken away, but it's out of bounds for a baseline inbounds play for the Grizzlies as Files will cue this one up down from the left baseline. Ball in for Minshew. Crossover, dribble, Teal. Good job moving his feet that time. Minshew looking to get a screen there as Teal tries to recover, and good job defensively, but then Joaquin Sheeler comes inside past Page. Page and Teal there. Nobody grabbed the basketball. And so Page going to commit the foul there. Mason Decker will come in next as Joaquin Sheeler heads to the free throw line. 4:48 left on the clock as Sheeler knocks down the first. Back to a 10-point game. Teal comes out for Decker. Sheeler, one more on the way. A little too strong. Warriors grab that rebound with Owen Page, and here they come into the front court. Into the corner it goes. Warriors throw it. Page is able to track it down in the front court, so the Warriors retain possession there. Caballero for Martinez. They'll work it around the left wing for Decker. Back for Caballero. Decker in for Page. He wants to go to work. Scoops underneath, up and good. Owen Page, he's going to work for the Warriors. And he's got 5 in the half, 17 in the game, and the Warriors back on top now by 12, a dozen-point lead. Page defending here against Files. Has to pick up the dribble. Give it up top. Jackson. Almost taken away by Decker. Mincho going to go down the lane and run into Grant Page there, and he's going to get 2 shots there as Page picked up another foul. Minchow, the leading scorer for the Grizzlies, and a timeout taken on the floor. It's a full timeout. 35-23 Warriors, Pinnacle Bank scoreboard. 4:04 to go here from Worland High School, the Big Horn Basin Shootout on the McKamey Broadcasting Network.
In Worland, King's Carpet One has become a trusted destination for homeowners and a valued member of the community. Discover our exciting new showroom, room by room, designed to elevate your shopping experience. A family-owned business that's also a good neighbor. King's Carpet One supports many charities in Worland and throughout the Big Horn Basin. King's Carpet One, giving our best to our customers and our community.
Hello? I wish I was a little bit smaller, a mini Shaq baller. I wouldn't have to yell when I talk to a toddler. I wish I had more leg room on a plane or a train. Life is tough when you're taller. Yeah, I shop it big and tall, but when it comes to my Pepsi, I like to keep it nice and small. A soft drink for your pocket, so light and refreshing, one sip, don't knock it.
So the next time you have to check out line, grab some Pepsi Minis, but get your own, because these are all mine, mine, mine.
35-23, your score, Pinnacle Bank scoreboard. Jordan McKamey with you here on the McKamey Broadcasting Network. Minchow going to be at the line coming out of the timeout. A little more than half of the third quarter remaining. Again, nightcap game here between the Warriors and the Grizzlies. As Minchow knocks down the first, he's got 12 of the Grizzlies, 24. Second free throw on the way. That one's too strong, and Decker can't grab the rebound, so the Grizzlies going to get a second chance opportunity here to break further into the Warrior lead. Files trying to get it inbounds. Through the hands of Haslam, who was trying to get it, but now it's taken right back by the Grizzlies, so stay here on the camera. Minchow with it. Warriors unable to get out of the defensive half here. Haslam, top Sheeler. Minchow wants a screen, and then the ball is taken away here by Owen Page, and he flushes it. Owen Page with a dunk. He was looking for a breakaway slam, and he got one. 37-24 brings the Warrior crowd to their feet. Minchow with it, in some trouble. Caballero, heavy defensive pressure. Now Jackson. Haslam going to take on a contested three. That one missed everything. Decker with the rebound. Here come the Warriors. Martinez open up the right wing. Didn't find him, though. Kidgel into the game as well. Caballero wide open. Left corner pocket, no. Long rebound almost taken down by the Warriors as it's saved in the front court. Back for Fisher Martinez. Warriors reset. Down low here for Page, and he's at it again. Owen Page, he's over 20 for the second straight game. 21 so far for the Warriors. 39-24, your score. Sheeler defended nicely by Caballero. 3 on the way here for the Grizzlies. No good from the outside by Minchow. And now Fisher Martinez gets it up the floor. Streaking to the bucket is Brian Caballero. And the Warriors, the gates are open now as they stretch their legs out to a 17-point lead. 41-24. Pinnacle Bank scoreboard almost taken away again. Minchow then lost it through his legs, and Kidgel thought he had to slide on that one. Actually took out the legs of Files, not intentionally there, as he again tries to offer some sportsmanship there, as Kidgel just trying to make a hustle play. Jackson will come out of the game. Johnson back in for the Grizzlies. Chase Harris comes in for the Warriors. 2:13 to go in the quarter as Page comes to the bench. 21 points for Owen. Ball into the backcourt now with Haslam. Dribbles to the right and gives off for Files. No, excuse me, that's Johnson. Now it's with Files. Haslam trying to set up the dribble drive. Good defense here by Fisher Martinez. Then Minchow goes downhill, and a blocking foul going to go on Harris. Just didn't get into good position, so a blocking foul underneath, and that's the sixth foul on the Warriors. That'll send the Grizz to the free throw line with Minchow. Shot up, no good for Minchow. Ryan Denise into the game now. Caballero gets a break. Shot up, no good. And it looked like Sheeler had an arm in the back of Decker, and then it's tipped out of bounds by the Grizzlies. Corbin Butte going to come into the game now. Denise, Martinez, Butte, Kidgel, and Harris out there for the Warriors. Three on the way for Martinez. Front irons, no. Fight for it on the way to the ground as Sheeler and Kidgel got tangled up there. Stays with the Warriors on the possession arrow. Kidgel's open right here if he wants it, but ball in for Harris. Working around for Denise. Harris able to bail him out in the left corner, back for Denise. Minute 25 to go here, third quarter. Denise, back for Kidgel. Now Martinez over the top goes, Files that time. Frustrated, but just went through his man a little bit that time. So Warrior basketball on the inbounds now. Ball going to come in now for Kidgel. Oh, and Martinez is coming open in the corner, but they don't get it to him. Martinez. Jump pass for Denise. Back for Kidgel. Down low for Harris. Give and go with Corbin Butte. To the hoop. Scooper's good. Corbin Butte into the book now for the Warriors as they head towards a 19-point lead, trying to break into the 20-point lead territory. Grizzlies looking for some kind of answer here as they'll go down low for Minchow. Kidgel there, though, to shut him off. Files thought about the contested three, then gives it up. Warriors a 20-3 quarter thus far. 43 seconds left in it. Johnson gives it for Files on a little backdoor cut. Nice job there by Files to finish up off glass. And the Warriors chance potentially at the last shot if they want it. 30 seconds left in the quarter. Denise for Martinez. Now Kidgel. Skip pass for Martinez. Harris down low. Shot fake there. Gets inside his man. Up and good. Chase Harris gets a deuce there. Harris with 4 points in the game. 10 seconds to go now here for the Grizzlies to get off a shot. Trailing 45-26. And that looked like an illegal screen there. And, yeah, that one's going to be called that time as Sheeler took out Fisher Martinez. You know, if you're going to get a foul, you might as well get a hard foul. Timeout taken by head coach Aaron Abel. Wants to draw some up for the last second shot here in the third quarter. We step away for 30 on the McKamey Broadcasting Network. Warriors 45, Grizzlies 26, Pinnacle Bank scoreboard.
is known for their industrial hoses, steel products, and trailers, but they'll surprise you with products for every customer. Check out Lazy One Clothing, matching pajamas, and more. Kiltech jackets for kids and adults, ready to protect you from old man winter. Stay cozy and stylish with Trail Crest blankets. Stuck? Not a chance with Yankum Kinetic ropes for every size ride. Give Hasco Industrial Supply a call at 347-6158 or stop in at 415 Bighorn Avenue in Worland.
Point 2 seconds left here in the quarter. Warriors going to inbounds here from the sideline. See if they can free up a shot. 4.2 seconds, a long time here for the Warriors. Ball's going to try to come in now. They'll get it for Harris. Give it off for Butte. Drives inside. Butte to the hoop. Up and good with the left hand. Corbin Butte beats the buzzer and he gets another one. Butte with 4 points now in the quarter and in the half. The Warriors head to the fourth, leading by 21, 47, 26. Pinnacle Bank scoreboard on the McKamey Broadcasting Network.
Owned and operated company in Worland, Wyoming, offering trucking services for a host of industries. They have done extensive work in Wyoming, Montana, North Dakota, and Colorado, as well as surrounding Rocky Mountain states for the past 70 years. Their modern and up-to-date equipment allows them to provide full-service solutions for their customers' needs, from start to completion. Swing Trucking, 347-4161. Swing Trucking is a proud supporter of McKamey Broadcasting and Worland High School Athletics. Sally's Classic Pizza in Worland, the classiest pizza around. Sally's offers pizza made with fresh dough daily. Go with a classic single topping or load it up with the king. 10 toppings in all. Friday, football and pizza is a winning combination. The Warrior Special is available all school year. Get a large two-topping pizza and a 2-liter for just $16.98. Fridays only. Sally's Classic Pizza, 1214 Bighorn Avenue, or call 347-2453.
And we're ready for fourth quarter action. Going to be Rocky Mountain Grizzly basketball to start quarter number four. Jordan McKamey with you. Happy to be along for the ride on this Bighorn Basin Shootout. Haven't got any update in the girls game so far. So the Grizzlies going to have to set up a stack here as the Warriors defending tightly. Ball comes into the backcourt for Minchow, working against Kidgel, and now they'll set up in the front court. Fake the drop-off here as Minchow gets underneath the bucket, kick it out for Johnson. Now Haslam crosses over. Nice job, good feet there by Fisher Martinez. Haslam dribbles out now, handoff for Johnson. Quick touch here now for Rylan Stebner. And then Corbin Butte reaching in. Oh. Now they're going to call an offensive foul. Is that on Minchow? All right. So the Warriors going to take over after the offensive foul call. Or actually, excuse me, they called that on Hayden Wambeke. Warriors backside for Fisher Martinez. Sorry, the camera. As Martinez now left corner pocket three. He splashed it. Fisher Martinez with another three for the Warriors as they knock another one down as the Grizzlies set up in the front court. Minchow with it. Now Haslam trying to get it inside for Wambeke. Cannot. Changes coming for the Warriors next as they lead it by 24. 50-26, Pinnacle Bank scoreboard. Haslam to the baseline, gets underneath his man, couldn't hit the shot, and Corbin Butte's there with the rebound for the Warriors. Here coming the other way is Kidgel. Give for Martinez. Skip pass for Denise. Steps down the lane. Takes on a man. Big bump there. Nothing called. Now it's a two-on-one developing the other way, and Haslam's got to hold things up as the Warriors sprint back with 6:28 to go. And the skip pass, no, as Butte tries to save it in but saves it right to Wambeke and puts the shot up and good. And just a wrong place, wrong time there for the Warriors. Good right place, right time for Wambeke as he gets a bucket for the Grizz. Cut the lead to 22, 50 to 28. Timeout here taken by head coach Jared Abel. 30-second variety, 50 to 28 Warriors. Pinnacle Bank scoreboard back next on the McKamey Broadcasting Network.
Here in Wyoming, we live by the spirit of the Wild West.
Now where the sun's a little brighter, where the snows that fall are a trifle whiter, where the bonds of home are a wee bit tighter, that's where the West begins.
We're the bank that's with you wherever that spirit leads. Because we're more than a bank in Wyoming, we're Wyoming in a bank. Pinnacle Bank, the way banking should be.
McGarvin Moberly Construction, a Worland.
Sorry to our friends at McGarvin Moberly. We'll get back to them there as the broadcaster got caught sleeping. 50 to 28 out of the timeout. Still Warrior basketball here. Decker, Swalstead, Caballero, Teal, and Page out there. 6:05 to go in the fourth quarter. Warriors on top by 22. Caballero, a little bit of trouble here as he gets it for Swalstead. A little bounce pass for Decker down low for Page. Shots up, backside, no. Teal got the rebound. He can't finish, and Files comes away at the rebound. A couple of good looks for the Warriors, but they couldn't finish. Outside the ball goes for the Grizzlies. Can't hit the shot, though. Nice job following his own shot that time. Files has that partially blocked, I believe, as that was a shot up by Ryland Stebner, but he couldn't hit it. And now a walk inside as Owen Page had the foot drag there, and the Warriors turn it back over. Five and a half to go here in the nightcap of the Big Horn Basin Shootout. Mention the Warriors wrap up the tournament tomorrow against Lovell at 12:30. Have that for you. Expect to be on the air around 12:15. See if the tournament stays on schedule tomorrow. As Minchow's in a lot of trouble, throws it underneath, stolen away by Brody Teal. And here come the Warriors up the floor. After what was, you could call, a sleepy opening half for the Warriors, they've kind of come to life here in half number two. Nice little dish there for Decker as he gets it here for Page. Tried to get a little position, and he's fouled by Files. Here goes Page to the line. So Page is at the line now. He's got 21 points in the game. And gets the shooter's roll there. That one touched every part of the cylinder before it decided to take a trip through. Second one for Page. That one front ends no good. And last touch by the Grizzlies will stay with the Warriors. 4:55 to go now as the Warriors start to try to chew up some of this clock. Page for Caballero. Now Swalstead. Again, Warriors don't have to be in a hurry here. Up top now, Caballero working around the perimeter. Swalstead shot fake there from three. Warriors can get that shot anytime they want it. Caballero back for Teal. Swalstead, right wing. Now go right baseline for Page. Now a three on the way for Swalstead. He buried it. Tyshawn Swalstead finding the range from deep. He's got eight in the game, and the Warriors lead it by 26. As Decker will defend right at midcourt against Haslam. And now it's tipped away here by Decker into the backcourt, but Haslam's able to track it down. Great defending there. And then the Warriors tip it away, take it away. An even break going there as they went for the behind-the-back pass, went for the highlight reel pass there. Did Swalstead looking for Decker, but he missed him. Warriors right now in control, 26-point lead, less than half the fourth quarter left, 3:42 in it. Outside Haslam, right side for the Grizzlies, crossover dribble. Caballero denies it. Wambeke stepping in, foul plus the bucket. It was that or a walk, and he got the foul call at the line for an old-fashioned play. Owen Page picks up what first personal foul, I believe. Not a lot of fouls in this one. I think there's only been 18 total fouls, as we're going to see mass changes coming up here for the Warriors. We'll see Michael Williams. We'll see Gunnar Mascaro. We'll see Cooper Cannon into the game. Grant Page as well, and Keegan Bush. So one free throw coming here for Wambeke, trying to give him his fifth point of the game, all of them coming here in the fourth quarter. Free throw up, missed everything. They'll set that one up down low. Didn't catch any part of the cylinder. So it's Warriors' second unit. See what they can do here for head coach Aaron Abel. Touch here for Mascaro. Now Grant Page outside for Cooper Cannon. Three on the way. Way too strong there. Backside rebound for Files. Then Cannon almost makes up for it by creating a turnover, but buckets up and good for Bryce Haslam. Now the Warriors set in the front court again. Outside for Mascaro. Now Cannon. Williams. Tipped away. Cannon grabs it though. Mascaro took his eye off it there, and the Grizzlies force a turnover. So a little bit of nerves here for the second unit to start their shift. Grizzlies outside now with it. This is Jackson, Tucker Jackson, out deep outside for Files. Front irons it, no good, but right back for Haslam. Files. Haslam down. Back it out and reset. Mascaro sticking to Haslam there. Jackson, ooh, gambled on the pass there. Almost taken away by Bush. Haslam gets a screen, and it's partially blocked there by Grant Page. Nice job by Page. And the Warriors come ahead with that 22-point lead, 2:13 to go. Williams lifts the head and gives it on for Mascaro. Now Cannon. Williams wants it, looking inside. Williams going to take on the three, though, and he buried it. Michael Williams for the triple there for the Warriors. And now a change here for the Grizzlies. So just going to stop and getting re-inbounds here with Files coming to the bench. So Michael Williams with that triple, big shot there for the sophomore. Head coach Aaron Abel's talked about looking for that next player on the varsity bench. Williams, a name that has been mentioned. And again, trying to make a case for that as the Warriors tip it out of bounds. Minute 39 to go as the Warriors student section and pep band start to taste this victory here for the Warriors, leading by 25. Ball inbounds now for the Grizzlies. It's been a 34-11 half here for the Warriors. Up top for Sheeler and the Grizz. Outside Jackson. Touch for Noah Johnson. High dribble there. Kick it out for Haslam. Looks to drive. Gets to the left elbow. Shut off there. Sheeler. For Haslam. Wambeke working hard there. Mascaro trying to stay on him. Johnson, nice little fake give there as he goes to the hoop. Count the bucket there as well as he got past a couple of players. Noah Johnson going to head the line for a three-point play. And coming in now, Stebner as well coming in for Bryce Haslam. As a three-point play attempt here by Johnson's coming up with a minute 9 to go. Free throw's no good. Rebound, though, by Jackson. Up top for Sheeler. Stays with the Grizz. Johnson, that Stebner tries to go down the lane. Sheeler. Little mismatch. Wambeke and Cannon there. So a little mismatch that time. Kick it out for Jackson. Hand off Sheeler. Less than a minute to go now. Sheeler's fall away from 20 feet is no good. Ball is loose, and Michael Williams has it, tries to outlet it up the floor, does for Cannon. And going to the bucket is Gunnar Mascaro. Gunnar Mascaro with the deuce there for the Warriors. So the Warriors get a bucket there for Mascaro. 23 seconds to go. Wambaki going to back down against Page. Lost the handle on it. Warriors have it. 17 seconds as he wants his Warriors to hold things up. Mascaro takes on the three. Head coach Aaron Abel told him to hang on to it, so going to be a little bit frustrated there at that last shot. 59-34. Looks like it's going to be your final here between the Warriors and Grizzlies. Great fight in the first half by the Grizz, but too much Warriors in the second half. Final score, Pinnacle Bank scoreboard. Worland Warriors 59, Rocky Mountain Grizzlies 34. We wrap it up from Worland High School in the Bighorn Basin Shootout next on the McKamey Broadcasting Network.
McGarvin Moberly is a specialized construction company with a focus on highway rehabilitation, maintenance, and reconstruction. For as many years as they've been in business, they've supported Worland High School athletics, and that tradition continues with the support of McKamey Broadcasting. McGarvin Moberly wishes good luck and success to all Worland Warrior and Lady Warrior teams this season. McGarvin Moberly, 60 years and counting. Go Warriors! Ladies and gentlemen, are your diesel engines letting you down? Need a fix that's top-notch, fast, and reliable? DPS is your go-to destination. We are fueled by excellence and driven by expertise. From trucks to trailers, no job's too tough for our skilled crew. We've got the latest technology to get your diesel roaring again. Choose DPS where you decide and we provide. Stop in at 1051 North 10th Street in Worland. Call us 347-4410 or visit us on the web at dps307.com. The Warrior Supporter Shield. Join the War Party. Through the generous support of the following businesses, this broadcast is made possible. Jay's Detail, located at 1626 U.S. Highway 20, 347-2071. Bryant Honey Incorporated, Pure Wyoming Honey and Pollination Services. Sage Creek Land and Cattle Company, with a special thanks to John and Steven Snyder. Want to join the war party? Call or text 307-431-1468 or email McKameyBroadcasting@gmail.com.
And welcome into the post-game show here. The Warriors and Grizzlies battle it to a 59-34 victory for the Warriors on the Pinnacle Bank scoreboard. Let's go into a scoring summary here for these two squads. Bryce Haslam with 7, Cole Minchow with 12, 2 points for Noah Johnson, 1 for Joaquin Sheeler, 8 for Leif Files, and 4 for Hayden Wambaki for the Rocky Mountain Grizzlies. For the Warriors, Gunnar Mascaro, 2 points, 4 points for Brody Teal, 2 points for Mason Decker, 8 for Tyshawn Swalstead, 4 for Corbin Butte, 22 for Owen Page, 4 points for Brian Caballero, 5 points for Fisher Martinez, 4 points for Chase Harris, 1 point for Grant Page, and 3 points for Michael Williams to give the Warriors their 59-34 victory. I got an update from Rocky Mountain from Ben Hoffman, 27-25. The ladies are leading after three quarters over there. So see if they can finish off that game in victorious fashion. The Warriors 3-0 today. Victory 195 for head coach Aaron Abel, as there's some interested community members on that 200 watch for 200 career victories here at Worland High School. Would be an impressive feat. But again, the head coach in charge, if you asked him about it, I'm sure it'd be the last thing on his mind. But you know what? Some of us in the media and around the community can care for him. 59-34, your final here on the Pinnacle Bank scoreboard. Warriors are going to play again tomorrow. They're going to wrap up the tournament against the Lovell Bulldogs. That is a real measuring stick game for the Warriors. The Bulldogs, an emerging team. They have a lot of playmakers on the team. They have a big man down low as well that Warriors going to have to figure out what they're going to do defensively against them. So should be a fun game. Make sure you don't miss it. 12:15 scheduled for the McGarvin and Taylor pregame show, 12:30 scheduled tip. Look out for that link coming out tomorrow. I'll make sure to text it to my friends so that there's a lot of places you can get it. But, you know, one way that you can make sure you don't miss, subscribe to McKamey Broadcasting there on YouTube. Follow us at McKamey Broadcasting on Facebook as well, and you'll never miss a link to our Warriors or Lady Warriors. Final score here from Worland High School, Worland Warriors 59, Rocky Mountain 34 as the Warriors finish up Friday at the Big Horn Basin Shootout 3-0. That's going to do it for us here on the McKamey Broadcasting Network, a 3-0 day. Hope you enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed bringing it to you. And until next time, and there will be another Worland Warrior next time tomorrow, Saturday, 12:30 against the Lovell Bulldogs. Go, Worland Warriors.
In Worland, King's Carpet One has become a trusted destination for homeowners and a valued member of the community. Discover our exciting new showroom, Room by Room, designed to elevate your shopping experience. A family-owned business that's also a good neighbor, King's Carpet One supports many charities in Worland and throughout the Bighorn Basin. King's Carpet One, giving our best to our customers and our community.
Smaller, a mini Shaq baller. I wouldn't have to yell when I talk to a toddler. I wish I had more leg room on a plane or a train. Life is tough.